Very good afternoon, dear children. How are you all? Hope you all are doing well. So, dear children, today we are going to start with the remaining part of the chapter Bringing Up Curry. In our previous class, we have already done the first part of this chapter, and today we are going to start with the second part of this chapter, right? The name of the chapter is Bringing Up Curry by Dhan Gopal Mukherjee. But before we start, children, let's take a quick recap of our previous class. What we have read? We read that the narrator is a 9-year-old child who was given a duty to look after a 5-month-old elephant named Curry. During the first 2 years, the boy could reach the back of the elephant with ease. Curry lived in a pavilion with a thatched roof. Curry fed on 40 pounds of twigs. Remember, I asked a question based on it. It was taken to a river for a bath. The sand was rubbed on its back for an hour. Then it immersed into the water. Later, it came out with pleasure and shining skin. So they both were enjoying their bath on the river, right? While coming back, the narrator goes inside the jungle to collect luscious twigs for its dinner. For whose dinner? For Curry's dinner. The narrator informed that elephants won't touch a mutilated twig. It could be easily handled if taken by its ears. One day in March, when the narrator was gathering food from the banyan tree, he heard Curry's voice. With an apprehension, the boy ran to where he left it. When he reached there, he realized that Curry might be drowning. However, it came out as a savior and threw the narrator to save a boy. It extended its trunk to come out of the water with lots of struggle and brisk movements of Curry. So I hope you all remember what we have read in our previous class, and just we took a recap of all those things, right? So children, now based on that first part, you are supposed to fill some blanks, right? And here are the blanks. So just tell me the answer of these blanks quickly. Curry was an very easy one. Who was Curry? Curry was an... Okay, you just think over it. In the meanwhile, I'm asking you next blank. Curry was dash when he was given to the author. The author dashed to reach Curry's back. And Curry lived in a dash under a dash roof. So write their answers quickly. I'm reading it again for you. Curry was an dash. Second is, Curry was dash when he was given to the author. Third, the author dash to reach Curry's back. The fourth one, Curry lived in a dash under a dash roof. I hope you all must have got the answers of these blanks. Now match your answers. Here is the first one. Curry was an elephant. Yes. Second one. Curry was dash when he was given to the author. Zachary was 5 months old. Right? Third one is, the author dashed to reach Curry's back. The author stood on tiptoe to reach Curry's back. And the final one is, Curry lived in Dash under a Dash roof. Yes, children? Right. Curry lived in pavilion under a thatched roof. Right? So these were very easy. And you all answered correctly. Now let's start with the chapter. Okay, here is your text. First of all, let's take a look of your key sentences. Curry becomes fond of ripe bananas. Ripe is what? Ripe is something fully grown or ready to be eaten. Right? So Curry becomes fond of ripe bananas. He believes in self-help. Much of the discomfort of his friend. With quite dignity. Now, dignity is what, children? Dignity is honor or respect. With quite dignity or with honor, Curry accepts the chiding he knows he deserves. Right? So let's read out the chapter. Curry was like a baby. He had to be trained to be good, and if you did not tell him when he was naughty, he was up to more mischief than ever. For instance, one day somebody gave him some bananas to eat. Very soon he developed a great love for ripe bananas. He used to keep large plates of fruit on a table near a window in the dining room. Who is talking here? Our narrator, right? So narrator used to keep large plates of fruit on table near a window. One day all the bananas on that table disappeared, and my family blamed the servants for eating all the fruit in the house. A few days later, the fruit disappeared again, and this time the blame was put on me, and I knew I had not done it. It made me very angry with my parents and the servants, of course, for I was sure that he had taken all the fruit. I was sure that they had taken all the fruit. The next time the fruit disappeared, I found a banana all smashed up in Curry's pavilion. This surprised me very much, for I had never seen fruit there, and as you know, he had always lived on twigs. Right? Next day, while I was sitting in the dining room, I was wondering whether I should take some fruit from the table. Look at the picture here. This picture must be surprising you. Who is here? Is it the trunk of Curry or a snake? Let's find out. Without my parents' permission, a long black thing, were very much like a snake, suddenly came through the window and disappeared with all the bananas. Let's take a look on our comic pictures. Here is the father who is scolding servants, and then to our narrator, right? The family is blaming servants, and then of course the narrator. But a few days later, the fruits disappeared again, and this time the blame was on narrator. And he knew that he had not done this. See, the father, he is blaming first servants and then to the narrator, right? And the next time the fruit disappeared, he found a banana smashed up in Curry's pavilion, right? This surprised the narrator very much, and he had never seen fruits in Curry's pavilion. Right, now let's find out what happened next. So without my parents' permission, a long black thing very much like a snake suddenly came through the window and disappeared with all the bananas. I was very much frightened because I had never seen snakes eat bananas, and I thought it must be a terrible snake that would sneak in and take fruit. I crept out of the room and with great fear in my heart ran out of the house, feeling sure that the snake would come back into the house, eat all the fruit and kill all of us. As I went out, I saw Curry's bag disappearing in the direction of the pavilion, and I was so frightened that I wanted his company to cheer me up. I ran after him into the pavilion and I found him there eating bananas. I stood still in astonishment. Now, what is astonishment, children? Astonishment is something of great surprise, right? And the bananas were lying strewn all around him. Now, what is strewn here is untidily scattered. He stretched out his trunk and reached for one far away from where he was standing. That instant, his trunk looked like a black snake, and I realized that Curry was the thief. Let's check out a related comic image to this part of our chapter. So see, the same scene has shown here as we have just seen in our text, right? So the next day when he was sitting in the dining room, he wondered after looking at that black thing. What was that black thing, right? Was it the trunk of Curry, or was it a snake who ate all the fruits, right? Okay. I realized that Curry was the thief. I went to him. Now the narrator realized that Curry was the thief. He went to him, pulled him out by the ear, and joyously showed my parents that it was Curry and not I that had eaten all the fruit these many weeks. So who had eaten all the fruits? It was Curry, not the narrator. Then I scolded him, for elephants understand words as well as children, and I said to him, next time I see you stealing fruit, you will be whipped. He knew that we were all angry with him, even the servants. His pride was so injured that he never stole anything from the dining room, right? So his pride was so injured that he never stole another thing from the dining room. And from then on, if anybody gave him any fruit, he always squealed as if to thank him, right? So soon, children, our narrator realized that the Curry was responsible for the mysterious disappearance of the banana, right? And then he showed the real thief to his parents and also scolded Curry. Curry was so ashamed that he never again dared to steal anything, right? and nevertheless when someone offered him fruits he would be readily delighted. An elephant is willing to be punished for having done wrong, but if you punish him without any reason, he will remember it and pay you back in your own coin. Right? So remember children, elephants are willing to be punished for mistakes. However, if they are punished without a reason, they remember it and pay it back. Fine. Let's move to the next page. Here are some more key sentences. Let's read out. Curry is a fast learner. It means he is intelligent. He masters all signals and sounds. He is taught. Means he is a fast learner. There is one lesson, though, that an elephant takes 5 years to learn. Right, and Curry is no exception. Let's find out what he learned and how. An elephant must be taught when to sit down, when to walk, when to go fast, and when to go slow. You teach him these things as you teach a child. If you say dhat and pull him by the ear, he will gradually learn to sit down. Similarly, if you say mali and pull his trunk forward, he will gradually learn that it is the signal to walk. Now, so this is what he was learning. He was learning these commands. Curry learned Mali after 3 lessons, but it took him 3 weeks to learn Dhat. He was no good at sitting down. And do you know why an elephant should be taught to sit down? Because he grows taller and taller than you who take care of him. Fine? So that when he is 2 or 3 years old, you can only reach his back with the ladder. It is therefore better to teach him to sit down by saying dhat, so that you can climb upon his back. For who would want to carry a ladder around all the time? That's correct. The most difficult thing to teach an elephant is the master. Fine. Before we move on, let's take a look on this comic picture. Okay, it is about the master call here. So here children, what we have learned, that elephant require to be trained. They need to be taught when to walk, when to sit, when to slow down, and so on. If you say dhat and pull them by their ears, they would learn to sit down. Similarly, if you say mali and pull their trunk, they would learn that it is the signal to walk. And our Curry, he took 3 classes to learn mali. How many classes he took? He took 3 classes to learn mali, but it took him 3 weeks to learn dhat. Right, so it was a bit difficult. So it took him 3 weeks to learn dhat. It is important to teach him to sit, else human would need a ladder to climb their back. Fine, because an elephant grows really tall in 2 to 3 years. All right, so let's come to this master call. What is it? The most difficult thing to teach an elephant is the master call. He generally takes 5 years to learn it properly. The master call is a strange hissing, howling sound, as if a snake and a tiger were fighting each other. Fine? How many years it took? A master call takes 5 years to learn. Fine? As how many years dhat took? Dhat took 3 weeks only, not years. Fine. Dhat took only 3 weeks, and Mali took only 3 classes. But this master call is taking 5 years to learn it properly. Fine. So it was quite much difficult. So the master call is a strange hissing, howling sound as if a snake and a tiger were fighting each other. And you have to make that kind of noise in his ear. And do you know what you expect an elephant to do when you give him the master call? If you are lost in the jungle and there is no way out and everything is black except the stars above, you dare not stay very long anywhere. The only thing to do then is to give the master call. And at once the elephant pulls down the tree in front of him with his trunk. This frightens all the animals away. As the tree comes crashing down, monkeys wake from their sleep and run from branch to branch. Look at here in the picture, the monkeys are running here and there, and our elephant curry, he is pulling out the trees. You can see them in the moonlight, and you can almost see the stage running in all the directions below. You can hear the growl of the tiger in the distance. What is growl here? Growl is bit of sound made by hungry stomach. So that sort of sound, fine. Even he is frightened. Like, who is frightened? Tiger. Then the elephant pulls down the next tree and the next and the next. Okay. Soon you will find that he has made a road right through the jungle straight to your house. Right? So, about this story was written by Dhan Gopal Mukherjee. So, what our narrator is trying to tell us about master call, that it is very important to teach an elephant the master call. The master call is a hissing and howling sound as if a snake or a tiger were fighting, right? And elephants need to be taught this call because this is the signal that the elephant needs to pull down the tree to frighten other animals. Okay, this is usually given when one feels lonely and frightened in the jungle. So the elephant can frighten all the animals in the jungle by doing so. So that's why this master call is very important to teach among other classes. Right? Let's find out this scene in our comic picture here. Look at Curry, and the narrator is giving him a master call. This is the most difficult thing to teach an elephant, right? And he generally takes how many years? 5 years to learn it properly. And master call is a strange hissing, howling sound as if a snake and a tiger were fighting each other, right? And you have to make that kind of noise in his ear, right? As the narrator is doing this in the curry's ear. And do you know what you expect an elephant to do when you give him the master call? Right here, the narrator is giving him a master call. If you are lost in the jungle and there is no way out and everything is black except the stars above, you dare not stay very long anywhere. What he do then? The only thing to do then is to give the master call, and at once the elephant pulls down the trees. See here. He pulls down the trees in front of him with his trunk. Right? This frightened all the animals away. Right? And you can hear the growl of the tiger in the distance, because even he is frightened of an angry elephant. Clear? I hope this chapter is clear to you children. Now let's do some questions based on this chapter. Hope the whole chapter is clear to you. Now you can answer easily these questions here, right? So tell, answer me first one question. What was the first thing Gari did? What was the first thing Gari did? Yes, children, what was the first thing Gari did? Write your answers in the comment box quickly. What was the first thing Gari did? Here is the answer. The first thing Gari did was to save a boy's life. Fine. This we had read in our first part. So what was the first thing Gari did? The first thing Gari did was to save a boy's life. Next question. Why the author took Gari to the river? Why the author took Gari to the river? Yes, children. Hurry up. Yes. Why the author took Gari to the river? Yes, the author would take Gari to the river every morning to bathe him. So that was the reason. Next question. How much twig Gari needed to chew? This question I asked in your previous class also, if I remember. How much twig Gari needed to chew? Yes. Hurry up, children. How much twig? Gari every day needed 40 pounds of twigs to chew and play with. Easy one. Let's move to next question. Sorry, here is how. How did the author lead Gari? How did the author lead Gari? Yes, children, answer it. How did the author lead Gari? The author would take Gari by the ear, as it was the easiest way to lead an elephant. Right? Okay, how can you say that Gari was a fast learner? This you have to answer correctly. How can you say that Gari was a fast learner? How can you say that? Yes, waiting for your answer. Good. Yes, Gari mastered all signals and sounds he was taught within a short span of time. Right? So he was a fast learner, no doubt. Let's move to next question. Gary was like a baby. What are the main points of comparison? Yes, children, Gary was like a baby. You agree with it? Yes. Then what are the main points of comparison? Answer it. Very good. Yes, Gary was like a human baby. He had to be taught a few lessons to become good. Like a baby, he too played some mischief. He used to steal away the fruits from the dining table. Right? Now, next question. Gary helped himself to all the bananas in the house without anyone noticing him. How did he do that? Gary helped himself to all the bananas in the house without anyone noticing it. How did he do that? Let's find out. Gary was a mischievous but intelligent creature. You agree? Yes, of course, right? So Gary was a mischievous but intelligent creature. He started taking away the bananas kept on the dining table. He used his black long trunk to steal fruits through the window. Let's move to next question. Gary learnt the commands to sit and to walk. What were the instructions for each command? Remember, this we did in the last part of our chapter. Gary learnt the commands to sit and to walk. What were the instructions for each command? Gary learned the commands to sit down and or stand up and walk fast or slow. The word dhat was the command to sit down. The word mali was the command to walk. Right? So this is an important question, students. So I'm reading it again for you. Like, Gary learned the commands to sit and to walk. What were the instructions for each command? And the answer is, Gary learned the commands to sit down or stand up and walk fast or slow. The word dhat, remember it, the word dhat was the command to sit down and the word mali was the command to walk. Let's do the next question. What is master call? The most important signal, right? What is the master call? Why is it the most important signal for an elephant to learn? This you have to answer. What is the master call? Why is it the most important signal for an elephant to learn? Here comes the answer. The master call was a strange kind of hissing like a snake and howling like a tiger. It sounded like a fight between a snake and a tiger. The sound had to be made in the elephant's ear. It was a necessary signal for Kari to uproot trees and make a passage through the dense forest for the house. Right? This is another significant question, children. So I am repeating it again. What is the master call? Why is it the most important signal for an elephant to learn? The master call was a strange kind of hissing like a snake and howling like a tiger. It sounded like a fight between a snake and a tiger. The sound had to be made in the elephant's ear. Okay, this you must know, that the sound had to be made in the elephant's ear. It was a necessary signal for Kari to uproot trees and make a passage through the dense forest for the house. Now, the moral of the story is, children, the story depicts the moral that animals to have the ability of sometimes being more caring and loving than human beings, right? This is what we have learned from this chapter. Now here comes your home assignments. These four questions you are supposed to write in your notebook, children. The first one is, give a character sketch of Kari, an elephant. How did the author struggle to come out of the water? And how did Kari help him? Kari was like a baby. What are the main points of comparison? What is the master call? And why is it the most important signal for an elephant to learn? Right? So these four questions you will write down in your notebook, children. So thank you very much, children. We'll meet you in the next class. Till then, stay happy, stay healthy, and stay home. Thank you so much and have a nice day.